Hello, everyone. My name is Emily Graber. Thank you for listening. Today, I'm going to present the Viva Contemporary Mobile Music Laboratory, which is an interactive artwork for the ACM MM22. This project has received funding from the European Union Horizon 2020 Research and Innovation Program, so we thank the funders. Also, want to thank my lab and Elaine Chu, the PI, for all of their help with this project. So, first, I'll quickly tell you what the Mobile Music Laboratory is. I'll give you context, background information about the larger project that this is situated in. I'll talk about the data that we're collecting, how all the data is synchronized, and a video demo which shows the artwork itself with the data collection. So the Mobile Music Lab is an environment for interactive music performance. It is also designed for empirical investigation of musical experiences, and the scientific setup is portable. And we've designed it specifically to study contemporary classical music. So, to go into a little bit more detail, the Mobile Music Laboratory is an interactive installation for listening and research on embodied cognition with focus on contemporary classical music. Contemporary classical music is often less familiar to listeners than other types of music, but its success is essential for composers pioneering musical and cultural developments. This installation gives listeners of any background a way to actively engage with contemporary classical music. It engages users to interactively control the temporal expression of contemporary classical music through intuitive conducting tapping gestures, while traces of their cognitive and physiological processes are recorded for subsequent analysis. The Mobile Music Laboratory and a data acquisition system make up this installation. As the user controls the music, lab streaming layer synchronously records gesture timing and audio, as well as neural and cardiac signals. The installation is designed to engender purposeful music engagement with contemporary classical music, while simultaneously serving as a mobile laboratory for studying embodied contemporary classical music listening experiences, thus enabling ecologically valid music cognition research outside of auditory psychology laboratories. So this is inside of a larger project called EarStretch, which stands for Enhancing Aesthetic Perception of Contemporary Classical Music, as you can imagine. And the larger project is about measuring and improving engagement with contemporary classical music. This idea has come from the fact that I'm a composer and performer and researcher, and I've noticed that people often do not like contemporary classical music, and I find it very interesting. So we want to document what's happening. What are the physiological effects of engagement? And is there any way we can improve people's reception of contemporary classical music? And can we do this with objective measures? So the hypothesis, there are many ways to approach this big problem, but we've narrowed it down to the role of temporal expectation in music reception. So we think that a lack of temporal expectations may weaken neural entrainment and diminish overall engagement with the music. So if we are able to boost up temporal expectations, then we may help people change their reception, change their neural entrainment, and this is what we want to do. So there are a couple ways we can do it. We can do it actively with a real-time control, meaning that people are actively making their own temporal expectations through their own body movements and hearing the results reflected in the music. We can also do it passively, where people receive timing information, such as through a vibrating haptic device on their finger. But the Mobile Music Lab is all about the active, interactive music control. So I'll go into that a little bit more now. There are many different parts that make up this demonstration, this installation. So the main part that the users are interacting with is the music. And whenever available, we use a disc clavier to play the music. This is a player piano, and it's a real instrument. If it's not available, we can also use computer synthesizers, which is what we're doing for the ACM demonstration. And both the disc clavier and the synthesizers are capable of taking MIDI, which is a numeric representation of the music, and converting it to audio. And the reason we're using MIDI is because before it gets converted to audio, we can change the MIDI timing. And this is what we're going to do in the installation. And we want to understand what's going on when people are actually listening to the music and controlling the music. So we have a number of different physiological sensors to measure it's happening. The first one is the Polar H10 heart rate monitor. As you can see here, it's just a chest strap that attaches in about 10 seconds, very easy setup. It's connected via Bluetooth. We also have EEG measures, brain measures. And for the ACM interactive artwork, we are using the Muse headset, which is also connected via Bluetooth. In the full setup version of this experiment, we're using a research grade EEG called the neuroelectric anobio system with 8 channels that can be placed on the scalp. And this also is wireless, connecting via Wi-Fi. And we're interested in having people actually control the music in real time. And in order to do that, they must have a controller. We're using the Rolly Light Blocks M interface, which can be programmed in a number of different ways, but we've just converted the entire surface into one button for people to press and give the beat as if they're a conductor conducting music. This interface is quite nice. It has a bit of depth to it, which is useful for helping us synchronize people's gestures to the music. And what we want is a combination of tight and loose synchronization, meaning that whenever they press, the music actually starts at that moment with a beat's worth of material. But in order to play the beat of material at the right tempo, we need to have 2 taps to figure out the interval. But the depth helps us also estimate instantaneously what the current tempo is. So when people tap slowly, we adjust the tempo down a little bit, it's a bit slower. And when they tap quickly, the tempo increases, it's a bit faster. So with all of these different parts, measuring everything, getting empirical data about what's going on with both the music and the physiology is a bit complicated. So we've opted to use something called lab streaming layer. And I encourage you to take a look at the lab streaming layer. It is made by folks at UC San Diego, and it's very useful for measuring multiple data streams at the same time. So to quickly recap the things that we're interested in measuring, we're interested in measuring people's gestures or taps onto the interface. We want to measure their heart, ECG, brain, EEG. We want to also measure the audio that comes from changing the music, and in addition to the MIDI that they're controlling, MIDI and audio are tightly linked, but we still want to measure it all just to make sure that everything is valid. So this is the setup that we have. Essentially, one computer is running many different programs. It's has the EEG connected, it has the heart connected, it has a max patch running, which is connected to the tapping interface. We have a microphone connected as well. And all of these things can be started all at once using lab streaming layer, lab recorder. So the lab recorder can gather all of the information at one time, one clock, so that we know everything is synchronized. In addition to these items, we also are obviously sending MIDI out to the disc clavier or synthesizer to be played. And in order to just keep everything organized and to validate all of our materials, we're having a second computer record the MIDI and with a high quality microphone back into Pro Tools on computer number 2. Now, conveniently, the lab streaming layer can take data streams from other computers. So we're going to send the second microphone data over to the lab recorder and also embed that in the recording so that we can realign all the MIDI and audio and make sure that everything is in fact aligned. So now let me play a little video that shows this happening. This is using a disc clavier that you can see in the background. I'm wearing the Anobio 8-channel system, and you can see the Rolly interface in my hands. And when this starts, you're going to be hearing a Ligeti piano etude. This musical performance is not especially musical, but I want you to pay attention to how each tap plays the music and how it can change over time. And then when the data panel pops up, you'll be able to see the taps that I'm actually pressing embedded into the data along with brain activity. It's the top 8 lines and the heart activity on the bottom line. So all of that is in one data file. Thank you. So a lot of the technology that I've been using is freely available online, and I encourage you to check these out. And I thank you for your time and attention, and please feel free to reach out with me with any questions that you have. You can see my email here, emily.graber@earcam.fr. Thank you very much.